The ijtihad of the Sahaba responded to the circumstances at the time. If you're at all familiar with Islamic history, we know from the first generation of Islam that the application of the Sharia was subject to the ijtihad of the Sahaba as conditions and circumstances arose and changed. Numerous aspects of the Sharia were applied by the Khulafa Rashideen differently than they were applied during the lifetime of Rasulullah. The hudud, for example, was suspended by Umar ibn Khattab for a whole year. Rasulullah himself did not impose the had punishment on Abdullah ibn Ubay for his spreading of the slander against Aisha. Look that up, why don't you? Jizya was accepted from at least one non-Muslim tribe, and jizya was accepted from mushrikeen of India and Persia, although the injunction was stipulated for the Ahlul Kitab. Zakah was neither assessed nor collected by the state under Uthman. Uthman added the second adhan to announce the Salatul Jummah, which was not the practice of the Prophet, but was added due to prevailing circumstances. It was decided the had would not be imposed on soldiers during military operations. Umar did not distribute conquered lands between the Mujahideen with only a fifth allocated to the state, as Rasulullah had done with Khaybar. But instead, he imposed a tax on the conquered land and left the original people in possession of it. Rasulullah punished people who drank alcohol with 40 lashes. Umar and Uthman doubled that. The ijtihad of the Sahaba responded to the circumstances at the time. None of these changes constituted changing or abandoning Islam, changing or abandoning the Sharia, or anything like that. They understood, and the Fuqaha ever since always understood, that the application of the Sharia must adapt to current prevailing conditions of time and place in order to best achieve the objectives of the Sharia. Genuine people of knowledge know this, and whoever denies it has no understanding of fiqh, of ijtihad, of Sharia or Islamic history, and they are not concerned with the best interests of the Muslims.